I want to be like that.
The Victoria's Secret show is such an iconic and legendary event.
Girl, you got the stars!
For every model, the Victoria's Secret Fest show is one of the biggest things you can book. Like, it's Victoria's Secret.
All right, let's move on to the Victoria's Secret fashion show. Apparently, it's over, guys.
The Victoria's Secret fashion show is an industry staple, which has been going on for 23 years. Well, until the 2019 show was abruptly canceled.
It's kind of true.
Could you smell trouble for this famous brand? There are tons of fans who look forward to the Victoria's Secret fashion show every year, and the models love it too. Being an angel means meeting sky-high standards, and top models like Adriana Lima counted among their greatest achievements. So it was certainly a surprise when model Shanina Shaikh announced the 2019 Victoria's Secret fashion show had been canceled. Although she was the one to reveal the news, Shanina didn't go into details about why the seemingly sudden cancellation was taking place. She claimed the company was trying to work on branding and new ways to do the show. Many fans were surprised by the news, but really, it's something we should have seen coming.
That's a lot to process.
The parent company of Victoria's Secret is called L Brands, and they also control Bath & Body Works and Pink. Their CEO is Les Wexner, and back in May 2019, we found out he was considering putting the kibosh on this annual fashion show. An internal memo from Les was obtained by CNBC, and it revealed the company was rethinking the show and the direction of the company as a whole. Even though the show had been broadcast on ABC and CBS for over 20 years, Les no longer believed network television was the right fit for this famous fashion show. Les claimed fashion is a business of change, and expressed a desire for the company to evolve and change to grow. On the outside, it might appear the company is doing great, but if you do a little digging, you'll see why Les was looking for ways to improve the company, not just so that it could grow, but so it could survive. Prior to the year 2018, an average of 15 Victoria's Secret stores would close over the course of a year. Of course, with any business, there'll be ebbs and flows, but things got dire when that number doubled to 30 closed stores in 2018. Things looked even worse in 2019 when the company announced 53 stores would be shutting their doors for good. That's about 4% of the 1,143 Victoria's Secret stores located all over the world. According to the company, this was based on the overall performance of the Victoria's Secret business not meeting their expectations or having year-on-year declines. But the company has always held up their fashion show as a key factor in the building of the brand, and if that's the case, then it seems like a bad idea to cancel it. However, this opulent event hasn't been doing well in recent years and may be in more trouble than many people realize. There was a time when Victoria's Secret was considered the cutting edge in terms of lingerie. It's how the brand became famous in the first place. They offered products which were more than just functional, and people couldn't get enough of them. In the past, the company has faced criticism from people who claim they should be promoting a variety of different body types in their advertisements and fashion shows. However, there was a time when the Victoria's Secret models were considered to be full-figured by fashion show standards, as crazy as that is to think nowadays. But the reality may be that while the company was once blazing trails, it's since fallen behind. It has to compete with retailers like Adore Me, Aerie, and Savage Fenty, who proudly offer products in a wide range of sizes and whose models reflect that. While Victoria's Secret has been painstakingly hand-picking their ideal angels, Aerie has been showing off unairbrushed models, which has earned them no shortage of fans. Although people were calling for more diversity in advertising, Victoria's Secret didn't seem interested, especially based on some statements made by their chief marketing officer, Ed Razek. He described Victoria's Secret as a specialty retailer and says they seek to fulfill a fantasy for their customers. Because of this, Ed stated he wouldn't consider hiring any plus-size or trans models and said there are plenty of other brands who do. Well, yeah, and it turns out people are more likely to support the brands that do, apparently. Ed claimed he's not trying to market towards the whole world and doesn't feel the need to be politically correct. But maybe casting a wider net for customers wouldn't be a bad thing. After all, companies which offer more variety like Amazon and Aerie are now serious competitors in this industry. According to Global Data Retail, over 2 years, Victoria's Secret lost 3.8 million customers to online retailers and Aerie. The comments made by Ed Razek generated tons of controversy for the brand. After the massive fallout, it seems as though Victoria's Secret may be trying to undo the damage, especially since they hired their first transgender model. Following news of the fashion show being canceled, it was announced that transgender model Valentina Sampaio had been hired to appear in a Victoria's Secret campaign. This is groundbreaking news and a historical first for the company, but it's not the first time Valentina's made history. She did so by becoming the first transgender model to appear on the cover of Vogue, when she graced the cover of Vogue Paris in 2017. Later, Ed tried to walk back his statements, admitting they came across as insensitive. Okay, so that's a great start. Then he said he would someday hire a trans model, he just hasn't even seen one good enough to make it as an angel. Yikes, he should have quit while he was ahead.
I'm not ready. Okay, no, I was just kidding about that.
Well, in fact, that's exactly what he did. Days after the lingerie brand hired its first openly transgender model, Ed announced his resignation and retirement from the company. Coincidence? Even singer Halsey, who headlined the 2018 event, was appalled by his comments. Following her performance, she slammed the lack of inclusivity in the show and mentioned Ed Razek's comments specifically, although she refrained from making statements about her employer. Shortly after these comments were made public, Kendall Jenner made her disapproval clear. She shared an image which said, "Celebrate trans women." Considering Caitlyn Jenner went through a very public transition, it's not surprising Kendall wanted to distance herself from his remarks. It doesn't seem to be a coincidence that while other more inclusive brands are soaring, Victoria's Secret is struggling. Each year, fewer people tuned into their fashion show, and the 2018 ratings were the worst yet. In 2017, the show was viewed by about 5 million people, which dropped to 3.3 million in 2018. The show has been hemorrhaging viewers for quite some time now, and the brand is also losing fans of its products. There was a time when Victoria's Secret was the brand. However, their appeal has been in steady decline. YouGov Brand Index measures the kind of hype consumers are generating about companies, whether it be good or bad. In 2016, women aged 18 to 49 felt mostly positive about the brand, generating a buzz score of 31. However, it soon dropped to a mere 23. The reason for this decline in popularity may ironically be the same thing which made the brand so popular in the first place. Back in 1977, a man named Roy Raymond was looking to buy some lingerie for his wife, but found the department store shopping experience quite awkward. The garments heavily favored function over form, and he was made to feel uncomfortable by the sales staff. So he decided to create a store offering alluring options in an environment men would be happy to shop. But now, women are finally able to shop for themselves and not just what they think men want to see. The fantasy Ed talks about, clearly one aimed at men and not the women who were the ones doing the shopping. Many women look for brands which feature a variety of different models, sizes, and options, and thankfully there's no shortage of companies who provide this. But for many consumers, Victoria's Secret isn't one of them. There are tons of models out there who have loved being a part of the annual Victoria's Secret fashion show. That's no surprise. But there have also been some models who have parted ways with the company recently, almost as if they knew things were starting to look grim. Model Carly Kloss became an angel in 2013 after working with the brand for quite some time. But eventually, none other than Ed Razek announced her departure by claiming Carly's schedule was too packed to devote enough time to Victoria's Secret. He said the two mutually agreed she would leave at the end of her contract, but according to Carly, it wasn't that simple. She claimed she was the one who decided to move on, and not because she was too busy. Instead, she found herself increasingly at odds with the company and felt their brand wasn't compatible with her values. Carly wasn't comfortable with the message Victoria's Secret sends to young women, and she no longer wished to be associated with them. Apparently, it's not just consumers who are troubled by the company's lack of inclusivity. Even the angels are starting to rebel. Then there's model Robin Lawley, who claims she grew up idolizing the angels, yet as an adult, she quickly realized they promote unrealistic standards of beauty and the lack of diversity is painstakingly obvious. When discussing the cancellation of the fashion show, Robin also cited comments from Ed and blamed the brand's inability to change with the times. In the immediate aftermath of his comments, Robin even encouraged people to boycott the brand. According to her, the company once had the power to totally change the game by displaying a variety of body types and they chose not to do so. We have a feeling this model isn't losing any sleep over the fact that Victoria's Secret fashion show isn't going to be happening in 2019. But there are tons of models out there who love being a part of the Victoria's Secret legacy. Alessandra Ambrosio called the brand amazing and claims it inspires her and women all over the world. Winnie Harlow was so thrilled to have the opportunity to appear in the 2018 show that she even started crying tears of joy upon hearing that she made it. Even in light of the controversial comments made by Ed, Winnie claimed that although they represented a step back in terms of diversity, she believed they could still move forward. Being an angel has been a dream come true for many models, but that's not universally true. Of course, there are extremely strict requirements put in place and sometimes it can be difficult to stay up to standard. Erin Heatherton claimed the pressure to stay slim was enormous and overwhelming, causing her to feel insecure and willing to resort to desperate measures to lose weight. Ultimately, Erin left the brand, claiming saying she didn't want to be a poor role model for her fans. So is this the end of the Victoria's Secret fashion show? It certainly seems as though the company has finally realized they need to switch gears if they want to stay relevant and profitable. Although Ed asserted the company is a leader in the industry, Les's memo certainly seems to indicate change is imminent. He mentions wanting to develop a new kind of event and acknowledges that we're now living in a digital age. It's a stark contrast to Ed, who claims he's totally given up on trying to use Instagram. It's possible that instead of broadcasting their fashion show on network television as they have for over two decades, Victoria's Secret will make it available online. In regards to their products, it seems like the company is struggling to revive their sales and find something that works. This includes going back to selling swimwear in addition to footwear and eyewear, but it certainly seems like they need to rethink their entire fantasy approach instead of just tinkering with the product lineup. It's possible hiring Valentina Sampaio will be the first of many positive changes designed to make the brand more inclusive. Perhaps Winnie Harlow is right, and Victoria's Secret will end up taking a leap forward after stepping back about this year's fashion show. Will moving away from network television be enough to revive the struggling brand? Or does Victoria's Secret need a major overhaul if they want to stay relevant?
It's very emotional.
It is for all of us.
Share your thoughts with us in the comments section and then click on the subscribe button for more videos from us here at The Taco. Bye for now.